In the late autumn of 1862, the Civil War was a year and a half old. Abraham Lincoln would replace the sluggish George McClellan with General Ambrose E. Burnside. Lincoln had grown tired of McClellan's lack of initiative after the Battle of Antietam. And although Burnside was personally very courageous and likable, he lacked the instincts and audacity that made a great commander. Despite this, and the fact that he personally felt he was unqualified for the job, Burnside would do his best, and he hoped to demonstrate the aggressiveness his predecessor lacked. Burnside would now devise a plan that he believed would destroy Lee's army. With Lee's command spread out all over northern Virginia, Burnside would assemble his army of 120,000 men along the eastern side of the Rappahannock River, directly across from the town of Fredericksburg. He would then cross the river, occupy the town, and attack Lee before he could concentrate his forces. It was a good plan, and it might have worked, except for one small detail. Ambrose E. Burnside was quite possibly the unluckiest general in the entire Union Army. The lead elements of Burnside's army arrived at the heights across from Fredericksburg on November 17, 1862. The first of the pontoon bridges that were to have arrived at the same time would take 8 more days to get there. So Burnside waited, and waited. Slowed by indecision and stiffening Confederate resistance, the Union Army would not begin to cross the river until December 10th. By that time, the force of rebels in and around the town would swell from 500 men to 75,000. Most of these were in strong defensive positions south and west of the town. The delay would prove to be disastrous for Burnside. On December 11th, Union engineers would begin to lay the bridges across the river, all of this while under a hail of Confederate fire from the town. The Union men fought their way over and forced the Confederates out. On the 12th, Burnside would finally get the majority of his army across the Rappahannock. On the next day, he would launch the great assault against Lee. The Army of Northern Virginia was spread out in a line over 4 miles long. At a point directly behind the town, they would occupy a sunken road with a stone wall at its edge to form a ready-made rifle pit. This strong position would be, unfortunately, the focal point of Burnside's attack. On the 13th of December, Burnside would demonstrate at Lee's right and then send wave after wave of Union troops at the infamous stone wall. Lee's artillery and infantry would shoot down over 12,000 men in front of the heights. Many Union men would freeze to death as they lay wounded or pinned down in front of the wall all that night and all the next day. Lee would lose about 5,000 men. The name Fredericksburg would come to be synonymous with Union futility.